Hello students, today in this video we are going to start a newly introduced topic to your curriculum. The name of the topic is Analytical Paragraph. Basically, it is a new topic introduced by CBSE in place of story writing for 10 marks, right? So it will be question number 4 of your question paper, and the word limit is 150 to 200 words. The question analytical paragraph that also comes in IELTS exam. IELTS exam means International English Language Testing System. So the CBSE has decided to add this paragraph to curriculum because most of the students they desire to sit in this exam. This IELTS exam is the world's most popular English proficiency test for the non-native English language speakers. So these are based on the charts, pie charts, tables, bar graphs, line graphs, etc. Let's know in detail what an analytical paragraph is. An analytical paragraph is a form of descriptive writing which is written on the basis of line graph, bar graph, pie charts, tables, etc. Word limit is 120 to 150 words. The question carries 10 marks. Format of this is introduction. First paragraph would be, you may divide it into 3 to 4 paragraphs. So the first paragraph of this is introduction. Second introduction, in the introduction part you have to paraphrase the question, right? That what is this line graph, bar graph or pie chart is about. So there you have to write down that. Second thing you have to take care is body of the paragraph. This body of the paragraph here in this content part means you can add 2-3 sub paragraphs, right? And in conclusion, you have to give the overview of your writing, that what the data is saying, is it increasing, decreasing, and what was the increase or decrease by the end of the data, through the data, or what is the information given in that. Now let's know about the features of the analytical. Now let's see the features of analytical paragraph. So analytical paragraph should describe the given charts, tables or data, etc. Whatever is given to you, that depends on the question. You can get anything out of these things. Should be brief and comprehensive. Whatever is given, that should be complete information in a way of that should be given to you. Next is include complete information. Should state the facts that are provided. Whatever is given, only that you have to write down in that. Okay, there's no need to give the data, the details or the observations of yourself. So use the simple and accurate language. I'll give you some special vocabulary for that, so that you have to use in that. Mention the figures and the quantities properly. It may happen the figures are there, the quantities are there, whatever it is, the units or the percentage, whatever it is, you have to give that, describe that properly. No personal observation is required in that. And preferable, it is preferable to you that you would write down this in the passive form. Okay, so these are the features of an analytical paragraph. Now let's understand in detail that what you have to write down in your introduction part, what in the body and what in the conclusion of the analytical paragraphs. I will give you some of the phrases which you can add in your analytical paragraph to make it more impressive. So let's see in detail what we have to give in introduction and body graph and body paragraph and the conclusion, right? So when this introduction is the first paragraph of your analytical paragraph, where it should be the brief, the paraphrasing of the question, of the statement given to you, you have to write down in that. And it should be just like an opening paragraph which introduces the topic
to the examiner or to the reader that what it is, right? And what is the information is given to you through this chart, through the table, or through the bar graph or the pie chart. So when you are writing this introductory paragraph, you need not to go into the details, okay? You just need to mention that what is clearly evidenced from the chart or the bar graph or something else, right? So that is the best way to write down the introduction part. Now I will give you some of the phrases which you can use while writing the introduction. So the first is, the chart given above describes, the table suggests, the line graph shows, the data given provides, the pie chart illustrates. Okay, with these phrases you can start your introduction with. So just take a screenshot of all this and note down in a notebook and try to learn this. Okay. Next thing is body paragraph. So as I told you, this body paragraph you can divide, you can give into sub paragraphs also. You can give here, right? So the first thing, when you have to write down this body paragraph, so that is the actually analytical paragraph that should contain the details of the graph or the data, whatever is given in your question, right? It should contain the important information, I would say, that what is the decrease, what is the increase in that, all the details, all the significant details in a way you have to write down in that part. And very important thing, that do not mix in one paragraph only, just make the sub paragraphs of this also. Now, the first thing I want to tell you here in the body paragraph, that if you want to describe the trends of the data of the chart, so how you will do? The phrases which you can use there are pattern of growth, rapidly doubled, peaked when it goes at the utmost level of increase, decline, fluctuate, plummet, drop down, etc. Right? So these are the phrases you have to use. And when you have to describe the quantities, then you can give like 40% of, like in pie chart you will give the information like this, 1/3 of, majority of people or majority of whatever it is, on average, approximately 5% of 5% of, etc. Whatever it is given, right? 5% of data, 5% of women, 5%, it may be anything. Right. So when you have to mention the quantities in that or the figures, the accuracy must be ensured, that whatever you are getting there in your question, only that you have to give in there. And there are the number of ways you can just describe this, by describing quantities, whatever it may be in percentage, it may be in fraction, right? And while comparison the information, when it is not necessary every time the quantities are given, so it may be information also. So if the chart mentions two different parties, for example, we will take men and women, right? So that refer to both of them in that particular analytical paragraph. If there is any contrast or the comparison, that should be drawn properly. And you must present that comparison and contrast properly with the proper words. That should be effective in a way, so that you can get good marks for that, right? And the last thing for that is, if one very important thing is establishing the relationship, which I've told you right now. So that the phrases you can use here, relationship between, similarly, in contrast with, in comparison to, but in opposite case, whereas, as opposed to, etc. So these are the phrases you have to In conclusion, last paragraph should be the summarize of the idea that is mentioned and the information you have given in the above paragraphs, that is in journal form. It should be concluding the nature and the act of the closing statement. It should look like that you are going to finish, you are going to end the paragraph, right? And here also, you should be completely stick to the point, right? And there's nothing which you will add from your own observations time. So that is the analytical paragraph, how you have to do, right? And one important thing I want to tell you, that when you will connect the sentences, so that the different information or the ideas you have to connect there. So that should, you should use the proper words, the proper linking sentences, linking phrases or linking verbs or connectors to link them logically, right? The sentence should be, the sentence of the paragraph should not be connected rationally. It should be, it should look nice over the, the view is that only whatever you will write, that should be accurate and it should look good, right? So that there is no chance of decreasing or deducting of your marks. So the, let's see next how we will do this analytical paragraph, and let's see the vocabulary of the analytical paragraph. So today we will, I'll give you only the vocabulary to be used in line graph. Now let's see which are the words, verbs, adverbs we have to use while describing this paragraph, means while giving the analysis of the bar graph, pie chart, line graph. So today I am giving you the vocabulary to be used in line graph only, and we will do that line graph only in this video, and next we will do in next videos, right? So the vocabulary to be used in analytical paragraph is, first one is the verbs you have to use, right? To which verbs you have to use, like for decrease and for increase. So the first thing I have given here with the decrease, this arrow is showing the increase in that, and this arrow is showing the decrease, right? So these are the words which are showing for the decreasing, and these are the words which are showing for the increasing. So if our graph, if our line graph or the percentage or the ratio, whatever is this, that is writing, so when we are talking about the line, so when the data is rising, so we will do rise, jump, grow, climb, go up, increase, and rocket. What is this rocket? This rocket is a very fast change, very rapid change, right? Suddenly when the increase is a sudden, a rapid increase is there, so there we will use this rocket word. So please keep this in mind, this is for rapid growth, clear? And rest words you can use for the increasing order. Next thing is for the fall. If the data is falling, if the decrease is there, so for that you will use the word fall, drop, decline, decrease, go down, plunge, and plummet, right? So these are the verbs which you have to use in your analytical paragraph. Now the adverbs also, just take care, like rise, sharply, rapidly, or considerably, steadily, gradually. So these adverbs are what? How, like how the increase is going, increase is there, is it fast, slow, means the adverbs you have to give. What are the adverbs? Adverbs you know, that adjust, that give meaning to the verbs. So those adverbs also you are advised to use in your analytical paragraph, right, with the verbs. So what are the adverbs? Let's see. Here we will see this from the downward direction, that the verbs we have, I have given here, the first thing is, if the growth is, means see, if the initial point is this one, as the growth is from this, means the slight, the small increase is there, so you will do slightly or slowly, okay? So this is number one, then number two, then number three, then number four, or like when the rise is you know, increasing. So here from the downwards we have to start. If the rise is slight, the small one, see, you can see this line, this is going a little slanting, right? So there, slightly or slowly. Next is steadily, gradually, or moderately, if it is going not very fast, okay, and not very slow. So there, steadily, gradually, moderately. And the third stage is when it is going
somewhat fast increase is going on here. So it is considerably, significantly, substantially. Okay, these adverbs you have to use. And when sudden growth, sudden, rapid, like we have used your rocket word. So same growth is has been seen in your line graph. So you can use these adverbs like sharply, rapidly, quickly, and steeply. Okay, so just take a screenshot of these words and adverbs and try to use these words and this vocabulary, I want to say, in your analytical paragraph. Next thing is for the constant. If the growth is constant, it is not growing, it is not decreasing. So what you have to do, like stay, remain, maintain, right? These are the basic words you have to do, and the constant, steady, and stable. So these are for the constant growth. If the growth is constant, so with that type of graph and bar graph, you have to go with that. So these are the the words which you have to use in the line graph. Now next we will see how we have to do this line graph, because in today's video we are going to this only, the line graph, right? So please take a screenshot of this and note down in your notebook. Once again I'm telling, these are the words when the rise is there, when the increase is there. These are the words when the decrease is there, the things are falling down. These are the adverbs which you have to use with verbs, and this is for constant growth, right? When the that is fixed, no growth is there, it is not increasing, not decreasing. So there. Now let's see one example of line graph, which is at the very first stage you should learn with all this. So how to start that, right? This is very simple description I have written here, and that you can change afterwards according to the vocabulary which I have given to you. So let's see here, line graph is given to you, and here units are given and years are given, right? It is not required to write down that on x axis it is given, on y axis it is given, because we are only describing it, right? We are not giving it as a mathematics, we are not doing it as a static or mathematic comparison here, so no need to write down x axis and y axis. But see, the thing you have to keep in mind, that whatever the growth is this, like whatever the units is this, that units is given in 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10, and years 2002, 2004, 2006, 2008 and 2010 is given here. Now, when the graph is there, so at the 2002, it is at 4, right? When we consider it at 2004, so it grows on 10. Clear? First this we have to see, because we have to just make an overview here first before doing it. We have to think for this. Then in 2006 it is at 2. Where it is? It is at 2. In 2008 it is at 6, and in 2010 also it is at 6th point, right? This is the 6th point, so we have to keep considered as a 6. Clear? So this is the overview we had made here. Now what does it show? That it started at 4 units in 2002. It peaked at 10 units in 2004, and whenever the highest level of this was, the peak of this was 10 units, right? So that I have written here, it peaked at 10 units, then it dropped by 8 units to its lowest point. Then in 2006, it was 10 and here it was 2, means 8 units decreased here. Then what I have used here, the words, see, keep in mind, this peaked at, dropped by, so these type of words you have to use in writing. Actually, this is not your answer, right? I have described in short only. You have to give a paragraph, right, of 150 to 200 words. So it dropped by 8 units to its lowest point at 2 units. Here we can see it comes here at 2 units. Then it increased to 6 units. In 2008, it goes to 6 units, and there it stayed stable, it remains stable there. It was constant, whatever the growth was, that remains constant in 2010 also, right? So it remained stable or constant between 2008 and 2010. And last point, it finished at 6th unit in 2010 also. So that is what the line graph you have to study like this, and then you have to give the analytical paragraph. Okay. Now in our next video, we will do the detailed description, detailed analytical paragraph of the line graph, and then one by one we will complete all the aspects, line graph, bar graph, pie chart and all. Okay, so till then, note this down in your notebook, revise it and try to solve this small line graphs in your notebooks. Okay, you can take examples from the maths books. It is available in newspapers also, so from there you can see that, and please try to do that with the vocabulary. Till then, good luck and have a nice day. Thank you very much.